Hi, this is Kemper Holt reporting for AV Showrooms, and today I'm going to review the Synergistic Research Ethernet switch, and it is a good one. Before I tell everyone about my experience adding the Synergistic Ethernet switch and the Ethernet cables, the foundation level Ethernet cables to my system, I think it's enlightening to tell you how my system works digitally. I have Xfinity cable, so a 75 ohm cable comes in from the wall plate and hooks into the Xfinity modem router. I have a Dell desktop computer with 14 terabytes of music, which connects to the router with a Cardis Ethernet cable. A Bricasti M3 DAC equipped with a network option also connects to the router with a Cardis Ethernet cable. When I was discussing the M3 with Bricasti head Brian Zollner, he suggested I added a network card, but I told him I wasn't doing any Tidal or Cobos or anything, so no thanks. Brian then went on to explain to me how valuable the network option was. Aside from giving me access to streaming services, it would eliminate the need for any USB cables or the widgets that decrapify the USB signal. So I opted to get the network card, and it has proven to be a great decision. Thanks, Brian, for that one. Now, for streaming or file playback, the signal goes through a very short path from the network board directly to the DAC, about an inch of connection. No extra component, no USB cables needed. I have personally heard USB cables sound substantially different from each other, especially in sound staging and detail retrieval. So not having to worry about another cable is a relief. The M3 connects to a VAC Signature Mark IIa SE by Synergistic Research Foundation XLRs, and the SIG 2A drives a pair of Frank Van Alstine's latest amps, the DVA 225s you can see here on either side of the bottom of the rack. It's a fully differential design, and it only accepts a balanced signal delivered by another pair of Synergistic Research Foundation XLRs. These small, unassuming amps pack a big punch dynamically, soundstage and image with the best, extract tons of detail without any edge or artifice. Cymbals sound real with long decays, and a Frank trademark, the string tone is spot on. Just sensational amps. An 8-foot pair of Synergistic Research Foundation speaker cables feed a beautiful pair of Alta Alec floor standers that I'll be giving a full review on later this winter. Now I'll tell you how easy it was to install the Ethernet switch. I used 3 Synergistic Research Foundation Ethernet cables. One connects the switch to the router, the other 2 go from the switch to my Dell server and the Bricasti M3 DAC. Plug in the Foundation 12 gauge AC cable, which comes with the switch, and you're done. Unlike many other Synergistic Research offerings, there aren't multiple levels of quality. The Ethernet switch is built to a top of the heap level. In SR terms, it is a Galileo or SRX status. Go big or go home. This is the only model they need. This is not a hide behind, haphazardly balanced, hanging off the back of a rack deal. This switch needs to be considered as any other component would be, solidly placed and displayed proudly. It certainly looks the part. The black chassis is milled from a solid billet of aluminum, and the top surface is carbon fiber, which helps eliminate the effects of vibration on the chassis, and it looks really cool. I was lucky enough to have a set of Signature Research MIG SX footers, and I put them under the switch, and I was good to go. I wish I could explain how the switch works, but Synergistic Research is keeping their cards very close to their vest, saying the switch uses active EM cell technology and UEF technology to condition the digital signal. Please go to the SR Research website for more in-depth information. All I can say is, whatever is in that box works wonders. I know my Dell server isn't a sensational component like an Innuos or Lumen, but it has been reliable, expandable, and affordable. When I was approached about reviewing the switch, my thoughts were, man, I just hope I can hear enough of a difference to make a review worthy. You know, otherwise there wouldn't be a review. When I change components, I like to start with the Cowboy Junkies Trinity Sessions, mining for gold to check the center image. Wow! Dead center, center stage, big church. Her voice had less sibilance than normal, and it decayed deep into the distance. Wow, it's a big church. Clamoring, vocals were just sensational all of a sudden on my system. Clamoring for more vocals, I played Jane Monheit singing Somewhere Over the Rainbow on my system. I'd never heard such clear, in-the-room, palpable vocals. It was just clean and effortless. Next, I played Nora Jones, Don't Know Why, and she was captivating. Now I'm noticing how clear the piano and drum kit were, separate spatially from Nora and each other. And I was surprised at how dynamic her voice was on this track. Again, just wow. Tracy Chapman was next, Mountains of Things. All the various percussion sounds were placed around the stage and clear as a bell, and her voice was spot on. Cecile McLaurin-Salvant, Melody Gardot, Carly Simon followed, then some men, James Taylor, Crosby, Stills, and Nash, Johnny Hartman, Stevie Winwood finished my thirst for vocals. I then put on some Gordon Goodwin's Big Fat Band, Mark Cohn, David Palmer, and the Royal Philharmonic playing Pink Floyd, Yo-Yo Ma, Led Zeppelin, Allman Brothers, Stevie Ray Vaughan. I couldn't stop. Literally, I couldn't stop. The first week after the switch, I was up till 2 or 3 a.m. just reveling at how good the system sounded. So different than pre-switch. I just can't describe it. It just kept me emotionally involved. So instead of my playlist of reference tracks, which I ran through the first night, I was playing all kinds of genres of music just to hear how they sounded. I noticed that regular recordings, even hard to listen to ones, were delivered much more pleasantly and were more fun to listen to. My overall take is much more enthusiastic than I've let on so far. This switch and Ethernet cabling have made a truly transformational positive improvement in my system. I simply cannot understand and almost not believe how the switch can make this much difference in my system. I can hardly contain my enthusiasm about the system. I'm flabbergasted that the switch could make such a seismic change for the better. And to think I was worried about hearing a slight improvement before I installed the switch and cables. The emotional involvement I feel from music is at least tripled now. I'm moved by both vocals and symphonies alike. It is so many things. Singers seem right in the room on good recordings. Their breathing and inflections laid bare. They have a 3D presence. The size of their heads is correct. The height they're at is correct. They occupy a separate space from the instruments. The size and atmosphere of the venue is evident in live recordings. In general, everything, voices, instruments, acoustic spaces, just all sound ridiculously more real. Even clapping sounds so much more like humans smacking their hands together, not an ambiguous noise that might be applause. I have tried to be reserved so I wouldn't give away my excitement about the switch. Now I can gush. The SR switch has made a bigger move towards my system sounding like live music, including the emotional involvement that lets music whisk you away with a smile on your face and your head bobbing and your toes tapping. I took out the switch and cables, boom, disappointed. So much so, I can honestly say, I can't imagine living without it. Congratulations, Ted, Andy, David, and the whole Synergistic Research team. AVS is proud to bestow our Product of the Year Gold Sound Award to the Synergistic Research Ethernet Switch. My favorite part of the review is the listening session. So let's just dial it up and listen to it now. Here we go.
My life.
Listening session with Leonard Cohen right here in the room with everyone. I don't know if you got it, but the low end just crushing through the room. I mean, it just thundered at the bottom, giving it foundation, and his voice, and it's unimitable. No one has that voice, or the poetry for that matter. So I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly did. I know that my toes were tapping and my head was bobbing. I hope you were too. So thanks for listening to that session. Breaking news. Andy, of Synergistic Research sent me a purple fuse. I've only had it for 2 days, but the moment I plugged it back in, first thing I noticed, bass. A little bit more extension, a little more oomph, a little chutzpah in the bass. Soundstage got a little wider, a little deeper, a little bigger. Spaces between instruments improved. Noise floor may have dropped a little bit. Bottom line is, the purple fuse improved upon what the switch has already done for my system. My suggestion is, upgrade to a purple fuse from Synergistic Research. Thanks again. This is Kemper Holt reporting for AV Showrooms.